This UCSD TV program is presented by University of California Television. Like what you learn? Visit our website or follow us on Facebook and Twitter to keep up with the latest programs.
Haydn nowadays is far less known than Mozart, whereas in their lifetimes, Haydn was a far more successful composer than Mozart. And Mozart had a tough time getting any jobs, and Haydn was lionized. He was the most sought after composer and the most beloved composer of his time. With Haydn, the cliche is that he is the father of string quartets and the symphony. And he was an incredibly prolific composer. And the fact that he lived away from the center of things, being in the Esterházy estate for so many decades, working more or less in seclusion, I don't think he was out of touch with the real world, but he was certainly much less traveled than Mozart. And unlike Beethoven, who was in touch with a lot of things and styles, being in Vienna, Haydn was really on his own. And he thought of also many new ways to express the ideas and the forms, and he developed a very unique language. And nowadays, I find it's a pity that Haydn is not so often played. I mean, if you'd say, well, name a great tune of Haydn's, you know, from one of his symphonies, even I would be hard pressed to really start humming one. And then you say, well, how about Mozart? And I can hum, 60-100 tunes that Mozart wrote. So it's an unfair comparison. But the fact is, Haydn wrote really beautiful music. And it's not just beautiful in the sense that we think, oh, it's easy listening, it's not terribly substantial. But the thing is, he wrote some incredibly dramatic works.
Thank you. Thank you.
I tell you, in this Haydn program, there are two set of works that are very unusual, because one is the clarinet trios, and then there's another instrument that in this program, the baritone, that went absolutely nowhere. It died. It became obsolete very quickly, and that wasn't even that popular in Haydn's time. But I think Haydn either liked the piece a lot, or one of his employers played the instrument, so he had to write numerous works for this particular instrument, baritone. And after I discovered this baritone instrument, I couldn't find anyone who could play it, and I couldn't find the instrument. You know, it's really rare. And I even asked some of the Haydn specialists or Baroque music specialists, where can I find a baritone? Nobody seemed to have any clue. So I'm very grateful to Shirley Hunt for having, you know, discovered this whereabouts of one particular instrument, and so she can play it. it's a wonderful instrument. I think the sonority is very unusual. It is a very beautiful instrument with, you know, an extra set of strings that you can plug, and also it creates this extra resonance. I think the audience will have a great time discovering this ancient relic. So the genius of Haydn is not to be overlooked. I just feel bad that, yeah, there's no movie equivalent of Amadeus that portrays Haydn. You know, perhaps somebody will do a movie about Haydn one day and win a few Oscars, and then people say, oh yeah, Haydn was not bad after all. Thank you.